what is up, mortals? It's Kiki Cakes here, and welcome to Fat Gum Deep Dive. Just wanted to greet you guys by saying sit back and relax, you're in for a treat, and so we begin. In this deep dive, we'll be talking about Taishiro Toyomitsu, better known by his hero name of Fat Gum. The earliest we know of his story is in the past. He worked closely with the police on cases that involve quirk-enhancing drugs and becoming familiar in cases related. Although, the first time we really get to see Fat Gum act is when he starts working with Detective Naomasa to investigate a new villain organization known as the Villain Factory. They investigate the rumors of the organization selling a large supply of trigger and discover the Villain Factory taking advantage of the Mascot Idol Festival to distribute the drug in food boxes. Side note, trigger is one of many different drugs that will increase the power of quirks, but the drug has the side effects of turning a user's tongue black and being very addictive after the first use. During the search operation, Agent Monica finds the drugs in the main suspect, known as Number 6, then calling Fat Gum and the police to help lock down the area. However, Number 6 makes the nearby cargo mechs go on a rampage, causing Fat Gum and Monica to have to help the mech operators, and thanks to Fat Gum's strength, they're able to save the people. Despite saving the people, this just pushes Number 6's plans further since the mechs charge at the containers of trigger and explode, destroying the evidence. Then seeing an opportunity in the confusion, Number 6 starts to run away with the police chasing after him. Furthermore, while the cops chase Number 6, Fat Gum and Monica go to deal with the remaining mechs. Thankfully, Monica is able to stop the machine and rescue the hostage, but like the other mechs, it starts to self-destruct. Seeing this, Fat Gum jumps onto it to block the explosion, absorbing all the energy, and when everyone is safe, he releases the energy at the cost of his accumulated fat. Although no one was injured, Number 6 was able to escape, much to the dismay of Fat Gum and police. We next see Fat Gum several weeks later, where he helps the police investigate operations at Onimura Pharmaceutical Corporation, which is suspected to be working with the Villain Factory, with Eraserhead and Monica even helping in a police raid on the company. During the raid, they arrest multiple suspects and confiscate possible evidence, initially not having any problems thanks to Eraserhead and Fat Gum, but when they find a secret lab, they find Number 6 surrounded by creatures known as bombers. Before they can stop Number 6, he blows up the lab, then flees with 5 bombers heading to the Tokyo Sky Egg to hopefully kill Captain Celebrity. Fortunately for Fat Gum and his allies, they survive the explosion, then follow the villain to the Sky Egg to help their fellow heroes. However, Fat Gum isn't much help during the incident, and thanks to All Might, there are no fatalities. Also, Fat Gum, Monica, and Eraserhead meet Toshinori Yagi, but unbeknownst to them, Toshinori is All Might. We next see Fat Gum in the main series after his sidekick, Tamaki Amajiki, brings Eijiro Kirishima to Fat Gum's agency so Kirishima can participate in work studies under Fat Gum, which he happily accepts. Later, we see Fat Gum, Amajiki, and Kirishima patrolling through a Shuha market where Fat Gum is trying various foods until a group of villains appear and he stops all of them except for one who runs. Before Amajiki can take them down, another villain appears and shoots him with a weird bullet that temporarily cancels out his quirk. Seeing that Amajiki can't use his quirk, Fat Gum questions the shooter while Kirishima chases after the runner. Once Fat Gum is done asking questions, he finds Kirishima and intercepts the villain from escaping while telling Kirishima a lesson on villain capture and quirk enhancement drugs. A few days later, Fat Gum goes to Sir Nidai's offices for a meeting about the Shiei Hasekai, who are led by Overhaul. During the meeting with his fellow heroes, Fat Gum stands up for his sidekicks after they get talked down to before introducing his sidekicks. Fat Gum tells his peers about the quirk-erasing bullet he obtained, going on to say that the bullet contained human blood and human cells. Sir Nidai asks the heroes there to investigate some locations connected to the Shiei Hasekai, but Fat Gum argues with him since they know Eri is a hostage. Nidai simply shrugs this off, saying he doesn't want to rush in like All Might and instead wants to get the possibility of saving her as close to 100% as possible before ending the meeting. Fat Gum and the other heroes summoned investigate for several days until Nidai figures out where Eri is being held, immediately calling for a meeting at his agency. At the meeting, they discuss Eri's location and come up with a plan to raid the Shiei Hasekai base at 8:30 a.m. the next morning. Once arriving, the police read the warrant before Rikiya Katsukame attacks the heroes and police. Ryuko Tatsuma's group tells the others to push forward while they deal with the villain. Once inside, they head to the secret tunnels connected to the property, but Joy Irinaka warps the tunnels, making the heroes fall into a room with the 8 bullets waiting to fight them. Amajiki insists that he'll fight the 3 Yakuza on his own, and Fat Gum believes Amajiki, then leaves with the other heroes. While moving through the tunnels, the Yakuza attempt to attack Aizawa, but Fat Gum is able to push him out of the way, then gets launched into another room with Kirishima. Before Fat Gum and Kirishima can get their bearings, Kendo Rappa appears, then immediately launches a rapid barrage of punches, striking both of the heroes. Once the barrage stops for a second, Fat Gum tries to retaliate with a punch of his own, but surprisingly, it's blocked by Hakichi Tengai's barrier. Kirishima is somewhat disheartened by this revelation, but Fat Gum encourages him, helping him get his head back into the fight. Once he's finished with his speech, they're attacked again by a barrage of punches, which Fat Gum uses to increase his power at the cost of lowering his defense. Thanks to Kirishima blocking some of the punches, Fat Gum is able to get an opening to attack with a powerful blast, knocking out both Rappa and Tengai. Once Fat Gum confirms the Yakuza are knocked out, he checks on the unconscious Kirishima, and much to his joy, his disciple is mostly okay. Before he can dwell on Kirishima's condition for too long, Rappa stands up, then demands that they will have a fair fight to the death next time. Fat Gum says that there won't be a next time since he will be arrested soon. The villain shrugs at this info, saying, "Then it's a draw," before showing them to a first aid room. Surprised at this, Fat Gum asks why he works for Overhaul and learns that Rappa only follows him since Overhaul has been the only one to defeat him. After this revelation, we don't see Fat Gum and Kirishima again for the rest of the operation due to their injuries, and we later see them in the hospital recovering with the other heroes. We next briefly see Fat Gum at the start of October, where he attends Nighteye's funeral and learns of the postponed Hero Work Studies program, saying goodbye to Kirishima and Amajiki. Fat Gum is then briefly seen at the Hero Billboard Chart Japan, where he becomes sad after listening to Ryukyu's speech. We see him again later during the second round of work studies when he employs Amajuki, Kirishima, and Tetsutetsu. At the end of March, Fat Gum is recruited to help with the operation to take down the Paranormal Liberation Front. During the operation, Fat Gum gets assigned to the team that attacks the Gunga Mountain Villa, with Amajiki following his mentor. Once Endeavor's team starts to raid the Jaku General Hospital, Fat Gum's team starts the raid on the villa. This attack surprises the villains, and in the confusion, the heroes are able to take down many of them. Fat Gum, Amajiki, and Tokoyami then head to one of the villa's secret exits to seal it after defeating the villains who get in their way. They then guard the entrance until Tokoyami uses full-powered Dark Shadow to repel the villains, sending them flying in various directions. After this, Fat Gum uses his super move, Fat Taxi, to keep Tokoyami, Charge Bolt, Mud Man, and Shimage safe in his belly until they get to a safe area. Tokoyami escapes Fat Gum after he sees a massive fire that is threatening Hawks. Fat Gum then releases the other heroes, telling them to run the rest of the way while he goes to get Tokoyami. Once he reaches the battlefield, he just nearly avoids getting crushed by the falling Mount Lady, then after a few minutes of running around the battlefield, he sees Tokoyami flying away with an unconscious and injured Hawks in his arms. Fat Gum then orders Tokoyami to take Hawks to the nearby medics, then get to a safe place before continuing to fight the Paranormal Liberation Front. Gigantomachia emerges from the bunker, then disposes of the heroes there, with the others in the bunker following slightly behind him. Fat Gum and Amajiki help the heroes there until they follow the other heroes who prioritize stopping Gigantomachia, and thanks to the UA students, they are able to catch up to him. Gigantomachia transforms into a larger and more armored form that defeats the heroes with ease, devastating the area with a single swing before continuing on his path. This is all the history we've seen on Fat Gum as of this writing, so now let's move on to his appearance. Fat Gum is a 29-year-old man who is typically seen in his fat form. That makes him a large, round man that typically towers over other adults. When in this fat form, his mouth is huge while his nose is just 2 slits, and alongside his other proportions, he has quite an odd look. However, when he burns through his fat, he's quite muscular and his body adapts to whatever his proportions are. His hero costume consists of black pants with an orange zippered hoodie that has his hero name's initials and an inverted F. He also wears red gloves with protection over his knuckles, metallic boots, knee guards with multiple protruding pieces, and a mask that goes over his eyes and forehead. When we see Fat Gum in the spinoff, his hero costume is slightly different, having only the black text initials of F and G. He is also seen with dark forearm guards. Moving on to his personality, Fat Gum is constantly hungry, so he's always seen eating a lot. He's also a very friendly and outgoing person towards civilians and his fellow heroes. He can become very serious in a proper situation and when he's focused on doing the right thing, especially when lives are at stake. Since he cares about saving as many people as he can, he dislikes lengthy operations, instead wanting to act as soon as possible. He's a quite knowledgeable person, knowing a lot about the criminal underworld and being able to see people's potential just by looking at them like he did for Tamaki Amajiki and Eijiro Kirishima. Moving on to his abilities, Fat Gum has the quirk called Fat Absorption, which allows him to adhere anything to his obese body on contact, sinking said thing into his body fat. His fat can store kinetic energy that can be converted into an offensive muscle at the cost of losing his defensive fat. Derived from his quirk, Fat Gum has enhanced strength, being able to grab multiple villains and keep a hold of them despite their resistance, and he's able to crush 2 pieces of hard candy with his bare hand. He also has enhanced durability, being able to take several assaults from Kendo Rappa's powerful barrage of attacks while staying standing, compared to Kirishima's unbreakable form barely being able to defend against one punch. Fat Gum also has enhanced agility, being able to react quickly against troubling situations despite his stature. He has quite a keen intellect, being analytical and attentive in situations and being able to make a strategy to take down Rappa and Tengai while he was worrying about his student and being continuously attacked. We also know one of Fat Gum's super moves called Fat Taxi, which is when he uses his quirk to hold people in his fat as passengers slash trap them. Thank you all for indulging yourselves in the story thus far. Hope you enjoyed it. Now there are a few more things I'd like to go over before the video ends. Firstly, if you're in the mood for some storytelling, Anime Deep Dive is a relative to 2 other channels. Our main channel, We the Celestials, and their sister channel, We the Celestial Naruto What Ifs. Both of them retell the stories of My Hero Academia and Naruto with a twist. I'd like to let you all know, on the behalf of We the Celestials, I'd like to thank everyone involved in the production of today's awesome content. Their details will be in the description below. If you're interested in what we do here at We the Celestials, then I would like to extend out an invitation to join the team, the only caveat being that we accept members 16 and older to join our crew. You can find us on our Discord, which you can locate in the description below. Our Discord is an all-around fantastic place to be, whether you're a fan or looking to join our band of misfits. All you gotta do is hit up the recruitment server and sign up for whichever category of work fulfills your interests. We're always looking for members to join us. That's it from us for today's video, so thank you all for watching and have a great day!